Hi guys, hi there people, it's me Melody again, and this is my second video blog. So on my first video blog, I talked about ways on how to choose a lifetime partner. And right now, we will be tackling about how to handle breaking up and moving on. Yes, because as what I've told you, I'm from a 7-year relationship. I had this relationship for 7 years with someone, but we ended up 3 months ago because of things that we cannot control, things that are beyond our control, and because maybe it's really God's plan that we broke up. So yes, in that span of 7 years, we really had a great time together. We shared memories and experiences together. But, yes, and that's the reason why it's really hard for me to forget everything. It's really hard for me to just forget him, because let's say that he is already part of my system. Because when I was still on the relationship, I thought that he's really my lifetime partner, and I thought that I would really spend the rest of my life with him. But I don't, and it did not happen because maybe God does not want him to be my husband, or God does not want him to be my partner. So in that kind of relationship, it's 7 years, so you can really expect that family members are already involved. We have the same set of friends. We have his mom and I were really close friends, and my mom and him are also sending text messages together, with each other. Then my father seems to like him also. His family seems to like me, and my family seems to like him. But then, maybe we're not just meant for each other. That's why it ended. So, enough with that. Whatever. So, by the way, let me just share to you some thoughts on how to handle breaking up and moving on. Actually, after that, it took a while for me to accept everything, but it's very easy on my part because we broke up while I'm here in Thailand and he's in the Philippines, because I was not able to see him all the time I was not able to see him, and that's the reason why it took it's just easy for me to forget everything. But guys, if you are in a breakup situation right now, maybe you're also experiencing different things than me, different things compared to me. But let me just share some thoughts with you, okay? So thank you for listening, and thank you for clicking this video. Okay, the first thing that I want to share to you is breakup is really not that fun. Especially when you really love that someone. There are no happy breakups in the US. Because it's the time of... Breakup is the period of mourning and healing for both people, and it's the time also that we can experience periods of adjustments, that you cannot receive any text from him, you cannot receive any messages from him, any calls from him. So it will really be a totally different and a totally different world for you, okay? So the first thing that you have to do in order to move on, the first thing that I did personally because I really prayed. I asked God that, oh yes God, why did you do this? Yeah, I was wrong because I questioned God. But then later on, I realized that, yes God, maybe God has other plans for me, better plans for me. God wants me to concentrate first on my career, on my work, on my future. And maybe God does not want him to be my partner at all. And God is trying to tell me that, child, you are choosing the wrong partner. It's not for you. So stop crying. Stop messing up your life. Stand up. Stand up, wait, because I am preparing the best love story for you. So after that, I also scanned the Bible, and then I had my devotions, daily devotions. I prayed a lot, and by that, and with that, God was able to tell me his messages. God was able to comfort me with his words. So that is that I can advise that will be the first thing that you have to do if you have or if you've been on a breakup. Second is you have to avoid seeing your former boyfriend or girlfriend. No, it's not being immature, but you really have to avoid adding them on Facebook. The thing that I did was I unfriended him on Facebook. I actually blocked him on Facebook so that I can't see him anymore. Avoid seeing him, because if you will see him, I am sure that you will just cry just like I did. I really cry seeing his pictures. And also, talk out your feelings with close friends. And I'm just lucky because during that time that I had this breakup, I can still remember that was January 8, 2012. That was Sunday. And after going to church, I have these sisters, my older sisters, they are my friends. And they sent me out to a karaoke bar, and we sang. They let me pour out everything. So it can really make you feel good if you will be talking or telling how you feel to your close friends. Because I know that, but you really have to choose who will you share your secrets or who will you share your feelings with. Make sure that those friends are the friends that you can really trust, okay? The next, you have to cry if you want to. It's okay to cry over a loss, but don't hold back. Let the tears roll. Just do it safe and in a private place. Actually, I really, really cried during that time. It took me, I think, one month of crying. But after that, I want to cry, but I cannot. There's no tears falling in my eyes anymore. I also told my cousin, I really want to cry because my heart really aches, but there's no tears and I can't cry anymore. So just cry, because I know that it really hurts. Just pull it out, okay? Let it go out so that you can feel better. Next is let go, put away everything that he or she gave you. Actually, he has lots of pictures in my wallet, and I burned everything. And he also had pictures on my Facebook, pictures on my cell phone, and I deleted everything. And so you have to delete it, because it will just remind you of the things of your memories together, and it will just make you sad, and it will make you cry a lot. The next is, do not focus on the things that your ex turned you off or just plain found annoying, or the things that the rude things that your ex is doing to you. Actually, my ex is a kind person. I'm not really saying that he's that bad for hurting me. He's really kind, and he have these good qualities also. But what I did after the breakup is my uncle told me to concentrate or think of the things, of the negative things about him. And I followed him. I think of everything that is negative about him, and that really helped me a lot, because that made me, that lessened my feelings for him. That helped me forget him. Okay, next is, you have to maintain a strict no contact policy and stick with it. Actually, I failed in that situation, because my ex-boyfriend, my ex future mother-in-law is always sending text messages to me, and I really failed in that part, because I was really not having a strict no contact policy. But right now I'm trying to do it, and so you really have to maintain a strict no contact policy, because if you will just keep on sending messages with each other, then, and if you will be asking everyone if what's happening with his life, then you cannot really move on, and that's for sure, because I've experienced that. So again, I know that it's really hard for someone to be left behind, especially girls, because girls are very emotional. Girls cry a lot every time they are heartbroken. It's really not that easy to accept everything. But with those ways on moving on, I know that it will just be a piece of cake. Right now, I'll admit that I'm still on the process, that I'm still moving on. I'm not totally moved on. But let's just say that time will come that we will just be laughing at those people who hurt us. And we'll just say to ourselves that, oh, this is the man that I wasted my tears. This is the man that I cried for. You will just say that. And as what I've said earlier, God really has a plan for us. God really has a plan for everything. Because actually, I prayed for it and I said it, God, I know that it's your plan, and that your will be done in my life. And God really answered it with a breakup. So if you think God doesn't love you for that breakup, then you're wrong, because God knows everything, and God is preparing something beautiful for you. So all you have to do, if you're still single right now and you've been through a breakup, all you have to do is just to wait for God's plan. Wait for God's plan. Pray. Ask God for guidance. And fulfill those things or your responsibilities, or make a strong bonding with your friends and with your family. And I'm sure it will really help you a lot. Okay? So guys, thank you for listening. Thank you for clicking this video. And thank you for your time, watching. Okay, so it's my second video, guys. I mean, yeah, second video, guys. So you just wait for my other videos. I'll be filming it next time. So thank you for your time, guys. Thank you for everything. God bless you all. Thank you for listening. God bless you. Bye. Till next time.